say thank you. We recognize that you are still our refuge. You declared in your word that your name is a strong tower, and that the righteous have the ability to run into it, and they are safe. God, we are declaring tonight that we feel and we know that we are safe in your arms tonight. God, you shielding us. You have been shielding us from all hurt, harm, and danger. God, we want to thank you for this gathering on tonight. God, we thank you for each individual that's in the house of prayer. God, we thank you for those that are watching online as well. God, we thank you for the opportunity to share the word one with the other. God, you declared in your word that your word would go out. God, that it would not return unto you void. So we're confident tonight that it will accomplish your will in the earth. Now, God, we humbly ask that you allow your servant Terry to decrease. God, that your spirit would increase in me. God, allow me to give it to them the way that you gave it to me. Then afterward, Father, we'll be careful not to take any credit. I'm giving you all the glory and the honor. These and other blessings we ask of the Father in Jesus' name. And each heart said, amen. First, giving honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus, and Him being the Christ. And if we were to examine His record tonight, we would have to admit that He does all things well. Amen. Thank God for this visionary pastor tonight. Would y'all give Pastor Brown a hand tonight? The vision to bring about these series of services. I'm thankful to him and the St. Mary Church family for having me here these two nights. Amen. You didn't have to do it. I appreciate the invitation. Amen. And thank God for all of these preachers here with us on tonight, especially Pastor Kelly and St. Paul family and the Jerusalem Church family. Choir sing out their sanctified souls. Thank God for the doorkeepers in the house of prayer, media ministry. God bless you all. Thank God for all the preachers' wives in the building, all the preachers in the building. Especially thank God for my wife for tonight. It was always with me. My son decided to come tonight. I was shocked for that. I'm going with y'all. Amen. So thank God for him. Amen. Blessed to have a son that reminded me around. I believe God is going to bless us again on tonight. Amen. On last night, we talked about the stages of deliverance. And I admonished us that if we would be honest with ourselves, that we are all going through something, one thing or another. And we all need deliverance from one thing or another. We do the best we can, some of us, to hide. Now we got masks, we can really hide. We do the best that we can, amen, to hide behind, you know, our cover, our polite smiles, our polite conversation. But oftentimes we're going through something and we need deliverance. We examine the case of the man where Jesus healed him by spitting on his eyes. And we took note that he had some good friends in the community. The text said that they brought him to Jesus. And then they besought, they prayed that Jesus would touch him. I don't know about you, but when Jesus touched me, I'm sure somebody prayed for me. And I didn't have sense enough to pray for myself. So my mother was shaking the walls of heaven and saying, Lord, where are you? Please, touch me. And we saw not only after God saved our soul that going to tell you my flesh in the way. I can't see it. Jesus touched him again. So tonight we're still in the Gospel of Mark. If you would turn with me to Mark chapter number 10, and we'll begin reading at verse number 46. If you would please stand. Mark chapter number 10, beginning at verse 46. If you don't have your sword, it is on the screen, amen, but you shouldn't leave home without your sword. Are we there? And the word of God says, and they came to Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. But he cried the more a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still. Doing things that Terry should not have done while he was yet spiritually blind. I would even go as far to say that spiritual blindness is worse than physical blindness. Oh, yeah. That is not the man upstate. He is not a higher power. Now we talk about higher power. Sharon Moss, she know a higher power.
Straighten it out.
Tell that preacher.
He is not one of the gods. He is not one of the ways. Same God that dwelt between the cherubims, that same God that got Jesus out of the grave, that same God is inside of you. This is the kind of glory of God dwells in us. He put his treasure in earthen vessels. Hallelujah, somebody.
Thank you, Lord.
So you have to recognize who God is. And say to God, when we don't trust God, we're showing that we don't recognize who God is in that area of our life. But we have to wholly lean and depend on Him. Here is Bartimaeus, finding, doing what he's supposed to be doing. And then Jesus comes through and he recognizes who Jesus is. Cries out and calls him the son of David. Recognizes who Jesus is. And the writer of Hebrews just tells us, but without faith it is impossible to please him. He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. God is able to do just what he said. So here he is, here's Bartimaeus. He began to cry out. He simply says, "Thou son of David, have mercy on me." If you're sitting here saying tonight, I want you to know God has already had mercy on you. When he woke you up this morning, guess what? He had mercy on you. When you were able to go out, he had mercy on you. When you were able to arrive safely at your job, he had mercy on you. When you woke up, your husband or wife was right there smiling in your face, he had mercy on you. You were able to make it to the house of prayer, guess what? God had mercy on you. If you could hear my voice right now, God had mercy on you. If you could lift your voice in this place, guess what? God had mercy on you. Listen, that Jericho Road was a rough place, but he was in the right place. So he cried out, "Thou son of David, have mercy on me." And then you have some dignified folk in the midst. praise dance. I mean, they danced beautifully. And then they started shouting and running. And listen, they wanted to grab them and take them out of here. I said, leave them in here. Grab some of them folk that sleep. this, kept on shouting, said, now son David, have mercy on me. Now, Bartimaeus calling Jesus the son of David. Bartimaeus was saying, he was recognizing that Jesus is the Messiah. That was not a popular opinion at that time. And just like the confession that led to Bartimaeus' deliverance. Any of us that desire deliverance from Jesus, we have to recognize that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Bartimaeus says, Jesus, please have mercy on me. Crying to God for mercy. You're telling God, I recognize that you have power over me. Recognize it's out of your will. You can do what you will with me. So God, I'm pleading that you would exercise kindness over my life. And all of us would have to admit the Lord's been kind.
Listen,
you gotta get rid of them negative nests. promise to be a good cheer. Then I want us to notice what Bartimaeus does. It's going to bless us. And he cast it away. It's gone. If there is anything in between you and the master, you better toss it aside like Bartimaeus did. It's gone. That boyfriend you've given husband privileges.
You have to talk to God. We got
except by faith. We cannot receive anything from God unless it is by faith.
Yeah.
easy way. Amen. I heard the Lord said that you have to pick up your cross and follow him daily. This way is not an easy way. I heard Jesus say that the foxes have hope and the birds have nests, but the Son of Man have nowhere to lay his weary head. My brothers and my sisters, now that you see Jesus, amen, I want to encourage you to follow him in the way. Follow him. blessings will be forgiven. Listen, remember that now that you have your spiritual eyesight, don't forget to follow Jesus. Some of us are saying, we're following our sin. We're following what we wear. Got to wear white on the first Sunday. We wear white on the first Sunday. All y'all want to wear. It's time to get rid of religion. It's time for relationship. We need a relationship with the Master. And you can't have it unless you follow me.
Yeah. wise thought. The God of all comfort. Patient, omniscient, immutable God that changes. A God that is the same yesterday and the day of your life. We come now to say thank you. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for being the understanding of God. We come tonight, O Lord, to cast all our care upon you. For we know you cares for us. We once, O God, was in the same predicament as blind bartimaeus. But when the Lord called us, and we answered that call, oh God, thank you for opening up our spiritual eyes, that we may be able to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. We thank you, Holy Father, tonight for your patience, your protection, your guidance. Have mercy if you will. Help us, oh God, to be honest within ourselves so that you can deliver us from whatever problem we have. We realize tonight, oh God, you are God that desires truth in our inward parts. And the truth of the matter, all of us need you. Oh God, we can't get along without you. Oh God, we're not being good like you told us to be. We thank you anyhow. We ask you, oh God, the rest of this week, that you lead us reviving down your storehouse. Oh God, bless your people. Give us open ears and open hearts. They will receive the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Have mercy, if you will. We pray for every pastor, every preacher, every lay person. We pray for those that have trouble on the other side, those that have lost loved ones. Have mercy, if you will. But while we know you call on it, because you say, we can come boldly to the throne of grace. We may receive help and mercy in time of need. We call on you tonight. We pray for those.
This is for a lot of people, you know, this time of year, everybody makes a mass exodus and goes out to the 28th May. So if you go to the travel, God bless you. God be with you, take you, and bring you back safe. God bless you.
Amen. We thank God tonight how He's blessed us today. We're so glad to be here with the Lord. Tell them to come with you. Invite somebody. Bring them if you can. And then if God blesses us on tomorrow night, we're going to talk about, have you been washed? As we get ready to leave, please repeat after me. No prayer.